all your health information in one safe place when you need it most. Visit MyMedicalRecords.com for a free trial.
And joining me now in studio is the newly svelte Mr. Bob Lorsch. He is the CEO of MMR Global, MMRF's stocks on the Bob. How do you lose weight over the holidays? You've got to be the only guy.
You made a comment in a show sometime last year about sitting on the couch and doing nothing but typing on a computer and being fat. And so I took that as inspiration. Okay, from you, it was kind of like my trainer to the stars to kind of incent me to lose some weight.
Well, I'll have a new career then. I'll be a trainer to the stars. Now, it's been a little while since we've seen you. I know a lot's going on with MMR Global. I want to know what's new with the company, but let's talk about the trading volume lately. It's more than doubled.
Well, yeah, we're very, very excited. In fact, one of our biggest days ever happened a few weeks ago when we traded more than or nearly 3 million shares in one day.
Wow.
And I think what's happening is more and more people are getting the fact that personal health records are a real important fabric product utility that's going to be required in our lives. And MMR Global clearly has the best, most versatile, user-friendly brand. We're headed off to the Consumer Electronics Show next week, where we will be showcased in the Alcatel-Lucent NG Connect booth.
Wow.
As really the first integrated personal health record in a suite of products, where a surgery patient goes home and uses Alcatel telemedicine technologies and Alcatel NG Connect partners to monitor the patient remotely, with information ending up in our personal health record. And then immediately after that, we have the HIMSS convention in Las Vegas, where 40,000+ healthcare professionals and IT professionals around the world will be looking at our products to integrate in their hospitals and surgery centers and medical offices. So it's a very, very exciting time for the company.
That's as busy time as I can tell as well.
Very.
Now, before the end of last year, you announced something about a $30 million licensing agreement. What's the latest with that?
We entered into a licensing agreement with a surgery management company that provides revenue cycle management for a variety of surgery centers and healthcare professionals in the western part of the United States to be able to utilize our pending, applied for, and issued patents in the operation of their business for their clients. And the agreement called for a $5 million payment in 2011, which became due,
mm-hmm.
and an additional series of $5 million payments based on certain notice of allowances being issued in a relative time frame for some of our pending patents. And the $5 million became due, the notice of allowances were issued, so we're very excited about the possibility that over a period of time we'll receive all the monies under that $30 million transaction. And it's $30 million plus additional royalties based on revenue that they generate.
Oh, that's fantastic. Now, I noticed this week you announced you had received two notices of allowances from the patent office. Is this pretty much what we're talking about?
Yes, it is. One of them came in last year, and one of them came in actually Tuesday. And in fact, I understand that last night we received a third one, which candidly we didn't even know about, and I guess really the first time people will hear about it will be on this show tomorrow. So we've actually gotten three notices of allowances under our method for health records series of patents, which gives us a broad spectrum of claims that we intend to utilize, license, and to the extent there's infringement, prosecute. So I'm very, very optimistic about the future of the company and its intellectual property for health IT. And when you add that to what we already have in the biotech arena with anti-CD20 antibodies and Favreal vaccine and patient samples and a whole variety of other IP, this company probably should be valued very, very significantly just based on its intellectual property portfolio.
Okay. Almost out of time, but I mentioned last year in a press release, late last year, you said something about a transaction. And is there anything you can tell us about that yet? And is that affected by the patents that we're talking about?
The company has spoken many times about the fact that we would like to grow by acquisition or being acquired and becoming part of another company that would enable us to spread our wings a little bit further. At this particular point in time, we are still aggressively pursuing several of those options, but the issuance of these patents is somewhat of a game changer from the standpoint of, in telecommunications, certain patents are life changers. For example, there's a series called the Katz patents, which were created by Ron Katz, where very early on he patented the ability when you push a button on a touch-tone phone, it triggered a patented action, and those patents were worth billions of dollars from all the carriers. And this patent really gets into the use of EMR, personal health record, health information technology. So we're kind of weighing how to value the company to be absolutely fair to the shareholders who have hung in with us in all the transactions we've been looking at in the context of those patents.
Tell me in 15 seconds why people should be paying attention to you right now.
Still very low price stock. 80%, I think I read recently, under the high a little more than a year ago. Lots of room to go up. Patent portfolio that isn't even reflected on the balance sheet. Celgene royalties that aren't even reflected on the balance sheet that are north of $10 million, assuming the milestones come through, which there's no reason for us to believe that they won't. And so it's just a great opportunity for somebody that wants to invest in a company that's fully reporting, that has only one place to go, and that's up.
MMR Global, MMRF is a stock symbol with their newly skinny CEO. Bob, thanks so much.
Thank you.